Hopefully you are doing well. Today's agenda is, in last class I was given some basic concept regarding the optical receiver, that is the photo detector, and I was also explained all the characteristics involved with the photodiode, and I was also incorporated some basic concept related to the photo detectors, and also given some practical scenario with the photo detectors, right? So today I will explain the first photo detectors, that is the pin photodiode. Since we know that pin photodiode and Evanjo photodiode APD is the most popular photo detector for the optical communication system. As far as the short distance communications, and you people have also done some lab work when you have applied at the receiver side the photo detector, right? So as you know, photo detector is just convert optical signal into again electrical signals, right? So first natural signal, electrical signal converted into optical, then again optical signal is converted into electrical signals, right? So today's agenda is pin photodiodes, right? Name itself explained. See, if the pin diode is there, pin diode is there, and the pin diode, we all are since this is the basic concept involved here, right? So if the P here is a N, that means the holes, right? Positive means holes, then N, that means electrons, right? Due to the force applied, here is appeared with a different depletion layer, so here negative, so here layer is positive, and if here is the positive, then here is the negative, right? So this is the simple, already understood, you people know this concept, this is the pin diode. But here forcefully or artificially we have induced I, so in that conditions your pin PN forcefully insert I, then PN diode is converted into pin photodiode, right? So how this will be possible? So please think, then I will explain. So again I will explain in detail analysis. So see, here is the PN junction, right? Now if I will forcefully reverse biased this junction, then what happened? Please think, then I will explain why this RL is required, right? Why reverse bias is required? Please think. So now understood the basic concept. Now since here is the holes and here is the reverse bias, so this will not neutralized, so negative neutralize the positive, so this layer will shift it toward this, no doubt. And here again this is the positive, this is the negative, so after this will also neutralize, so this layer is also shifted here, so this point is shifted this side, left side, and this point is shifted right side. Understood? So now these PN junctions will be appeared look like this. Appear like this. See, so here is N, here is I, and insert, because forcefully artificially you have inserted the one layer, that's why this name is insert layer. And this is P, and this is the one concept is very important. This one is highly shifted rather than this, so this weight W and this weight is W dash, but W is greater than W dash, right? This one is a higher shifting because directly connected with this, and this is you people also known the concept of diffusion and depletion concept, diffusion and diffuse layer. So that's why this one is highly shifted left side, and this is lesser shifted the right side, right? So now this is the layer is a forcefully insert, right? So if the eye layer will insert, then what is the benefit? What is the benefit? Now, initially, the only this point is responsible to inject the photon. Photon, where the photon came? Since we already known for here's the photodiode, pin diode or APD just there. Now a photon will be strikes. Due to photon strikes, the recombinations will be appear, and due to the high rated recombinations, they will generate the output with the high data rate, right? So why I layer is required? Because the this area is increased so that rate of recombinations can be increased. So the sensitivity of the pin PN diode is not so much good as compared to the pin diode, because now the surface, this surface is very, very larger, and larger amount of photons can strike, larger energy can be generated, and due to the combination of that packet, high amount of photon will be generated, and due to the generations of the photons, the conversion is rate is high, right? So high amount, how high data rate will be supports due to this I layer, right? So the basic concept of the pin diode is the totally based on the PN diode, only the reverse bias is there, and due to this reverse bias, this will shift it here, this will shift it here. Now I will appear. So now anyone can understand how PN diode is converted into pin diode. Pin diode, that is a photo detector, right? Now, what is the role of this RL? Since we know that this circuit, the current will be appeared, and the current will drive only with the faster rate when the load is applied. So this RL is a, when if RL value is very, very high, load is very, very high, then faster rate of current will be drawn, right? So this is the concept related with the PN to pin diode. This is the conversion of PN to PN diode. But what is the circuit analysis of this pin diode? We will cover in next slide. See, now here we have drawn the PN circuit diagram, and how basically they will apply. How will they apply in optical communications, right? Only conversion of PN to pin is not sufficient, right? Because at the receiver or channel response of the any communication system, it supports 3 dB bandwidth. 3 dB bandwidth, right? Right? 3 dB bandwidth. And 3 dB bandwidth, when you will observe minutely, then this supports this 3D bandwidth nature is combination of low pass as well as high pass nature, right? So low pass and high pass, how they will appear, how they will support the 3dB? So that concept is related with this circuit analysis. So how? See, now since this is the photodetector, so photodetector applied again the incident of photon, like here, since here incident of photon I, here incident for h mu, incident of photon is strike, so here photon is a strike, like here, with the power, some power value P0 or something. Now due to, since the driving load is RL, so RL is here. So across this RL, voltage drop is V0. Since this is very, very higher, and the current drop is very, very higher, so
since conversion from electrical to optical or optical to electrical, they might be damaged or the circuit or provide the some fluctuations. To reduce the fluctuations as well as that to overcome the damage of the circuit, here we apply the buffer. Buffer is very, very helpful to protect the circuit and also helps to minimize the fluctuation in the circuit. Now, since this is a RL, so this will be directly in phase here. So this is the open operational amplifier. So operational amplifier is there. So if the incident drop is very higher due to RL is higher. So RL is higher, so input impedance is very, very high. So output impedance should be low, right? So low output impedance is very good. Those is required for the any circuit. But finally, we are looking for the 3D bandwidth support, because after the final output, the channel bandwidth should be is look like this, the 3D bandwidth. So how they will appear? So due to the nature of the constant current device, they will pass through the equalizer. Or please remember how you can define the equalizer. Equalizer is the basic concept is they will also the combination of low pass filter as well as high pass filter. So if you will combine, low pass filter nature here, and if you will combine high pass filter nature, right? So when you combine both, then the nature of this, is behaves like this band pass nature, right? And you will compare this, then the nature will look like particle nature will look like this. That means upper frequency F2 and F1. So how much bandwidth support? F2 minus F1. Bandwidth support is F2 minus F1. And this bandwidth is directly supports as a 3D bandwidth. So why equalizer is required at the pin photodiode circuit? Due to this, right? But how this low pass filter frequency response look like this, or frequency response look like this? So this will explain in the AC circuit analysis. AC circuit analysis of the photo detector. AC circuit analysis. So now this circuit will convert into AC circuit analysis. So see here. Now again, incident photon is there. This is the current dependent source, IP, photo detector current. So IP. This is the junction, because when the any junction will appear, then the junction capacitance is there. RL is the load, right? And this value is involved. This value is involved due to this value is involved RA and CA due to the amplifier. This RA and CA amplifier resistance and capacitance is there, right? Now, after the minute observation of this circuit, we have concluded that this CA, this CJ, both are capacitance, both are the parallel. So C effective is CA parallel to CJ. And we know that CA, when the two capacitor is in parallel, then they are combined, right? Same RL and RA, RL and RA, both are again parallel. So again, equivalent is this. So here C equivalent equal to CA plus CJ, and R equivalent is equal to RL, RA, RL plus RA. But here RL is very, very larger than RA, because load resistance is very, very larger. Load resistance is very, very larger as compared to operational amplifier resistance. So this is can similar to RL. So since for the discharging or charging nature of the any circuit is depends on tau, right? Tau, and tau is nothing but the R equivalent and C equivalent. So on the basis of this, we can plot this value as this or this. And when this is the low pass filter, this is the high pass filter, when you combine both by the equalizer, we can get this 3 dB bandwidth.
So finally you observe that our output of this circuit will provide the 3D wave bandwidth output. Hence finally we have observed that our PN diode is conversion of PIN diode with the is justified the output concept, output nature of the 3 dB bandwidth, and this concept will have also proved by me through the circuit analysis, DC circuit analysis as well as AC circuit analysis. And so finally we have concluded that PIN diode is very much suitable for to detect the incident photon and process the photon in the outputs as an output signal. Green signal, that is the optical signal, will convert it into electrical signal. At output of this photo detector, now we can add the filter and then analyzer. An analyzer, BE analyzer, quality factor analyzer. After this, we can able to trace the same output, those information has sent by an user. So again, I will relate that your previous lecture to this lecture. When your mom will send the informations, hi Bittu, how are you, then you can also receive the hi Bittu, how are you, not receive hi Bittu, how are you, because in same nature you have received, right? So nature at the transmitter, that is natural signal, are able to receive through at the receiver by the PIN diode with the 3 dB bandwidth nature. So hopefully you have some idea or you are able to understood that PIN diode, how PN diode is converted into PIN, what is the circuit analysis, what is the AC circuit analysis, how the charging discharging phenomenon is appeared in the PIN photodiode. And next lecture I will continue the response time analysis. Hopefully this lecture will provide some basic idea about the photodetector. Thank you.